everybody. This is Same Sis.
But different.
And I'm your girl, Shay Live.
And I'm Aja.
And today we have a really, really cool topic. We're going to be talking about the power of the pivot. If you don't know what that means, you're in for a treat because this is going to help you in every aspect of your life, especially if you're in your 20s, because I can almost guarantee that this is happening to you right now.
Did you check my physical form of pivot?
Okay. It was like a neck pivot?
Yeah, I've been giving life physicalities nowadays just to give myself, you know, a boost. What's been going on with you?
Wait, before we do we cheers?
Yes.
What are we cheersing to today?
First, let's tell them what we're cheersing.
So we normally drink wine or a mixed drink, but today we are drinking protein shakes. Well, mine's a protein shake and hers is a fruit smoothie.
I'm getting there with putting protein in. I don't like the taste, but we're being healthy. So cheers to health and wealth.
Cheers. But to answer your question as far as like what I did this past week since I've seen you guys, i.e. this protein shake, I've been sticking to my 2020 resolutions, my life-changing goals.
You and even have an app to...
Yeah, I'm like counting calories, I'm working out, I'm protein shaking, you know what I'm saying? So...
I'm proud of you.
Thank you. I've been working on my temper, I haven't meditated yet. I really...
That one takes time.
It takes a little time. But I do take time to myself, put on some music, and like set out my day. Yeah, yeah.
Nice. I've been doing the same.
Yes.
I've been really trying to concentrate on that. Because I'm like, girl, if you're really trying to be that woman that you know you are destined to be, stick with it, darling. And I am.
Perfect.
And it takes 21 days to break a habit.
So. Yes, 90 days to change your lifestyle.
So
we got.
We'll check in.
We got some more things.
We'll check in after 90 days. But
yes,
I am hungry, but I have seen one abdomen, so I'm.
That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not tooting my own horn now, but.
Speaking of doing things intentionally, like changing your diet or working out or anything like that.
Yes.
We're going to be talking about the power of the pivot, which can be intentional or unintentional. And basically a pivot in life is when you change the direction from your original plan. So,
very good explanation.
Thank you. I mean, you know, in case anybody doesn't know, I feel like most people probably understand what a pivot is, but just in case.
Well, the intentional life pivot is what we're talking about.
Yes. And when I said everybody can kind of relate to it is because you don't always have these pivots by choice. Like... For me, personally, most of my pivots were unintentional, so...
Darling, mine were, like, godsend, and I only figured out I was in the pivot when I had already pivoted.
Yeah. No, seriously, they come, like, when you least expect them, sometimes at the worst times, but we're talking about the power of it, where you can, you know, that's where you grow the most.
We basically got the title and the actual, like... power of the pivot and what we've kind of been a little bit obsessed with it since we did this we went to like a woman's luncheon that it was on an Instagram like sponsor and I was like, Shayna, this is something that we should probably go to, like women's empowerment, entrepreneurship, goal setting, like it was
all women who had their own businesses.
Yeah.
And so it was really cool.
Yeah, it was really cool. And we had a panel of like dope women kind of expressing their journeys through.
Shout out to Jen.
Okay. And yeah, we learned a ton. It was like an all-day luncheon, panel discussion. It was great for networking, but I think the biggest thing that we went out of it or got out of it was the power of the pivot conversation, which was like every time they were saying something that was like directly relating to our lives, we'd be like,
and you know, like when you add a panel, you start writing stuff down. I remember power of the pivot so big because I was like, wow, yeah, that's what it is. That's just happening in my life.
But it was cool because now we get to put a name and a title to something that sometimes is not as positive or you get a little bit worked up at, and you can like understand better, like, okay, I'm in a pivot phase and I need to encourage myself and be positive about it instead of being like, ah!
Literally.
So yeah, that's where we got power of the pivot.
Sorry to break, but I didn't put any lipstick on. I didn't put any lip gloss on. So give me one second.
Well, now that we're taking a small lipstick break, what are you wearing?
Fenty Beauty, Fussy.
Do you think it, do you like her lip stuff?
Love it.
See, I've heard great things about her lip stuff, but I've also heard that if you have dry skin, that her foundations are a little too mattifying and that they're not great. Have you tried her foundation?
I have.
Do you like it?
I don't have dry skin though.
Ah, so you're good.
Yeah, I have like normal, it's like oily, normal, and dry.
Combination.
Maybe I have combination skin. But I will say, I did use her foundation and I did like it. It just ran out so fast.
Yeah, it's she doesn't have that much.
And it's like, it looks like a big ass tube.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not a lot of product in there.
Luxury makeup.
But it is good though.
Okay. Love it.
Thanks. Okay, so back to Power of the Pivot.
Yes.
Are you experiencing a pivot right now?
Always.
Or... always for real?
No. But I think that now that I understand what Power of the Pivot is, which is just like a glorified change, unexpected or not, I think that there's tons of it, but I think huge pivots, right now, maybe two currently right now.
Okay.
Which are very clearly me going from like a single woman in the government size to becoming a wife. That's like a whole internal pivot that I am required to do. So I'm learning a ton in that. And then I think career-wise, that's a huge pivot for me. Where I'm like, I feel like a baby learning a lot of shit for the first time, because I'm like, wow, I had one career for so long that now I'm in the beginning stage of another one, and that is like, I'm learning things that I'm like, oh man, I think I should know this by now, or like...
Okay, well, explain to people who don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, so, for 10 years I've been out here dancing, backup, music videos, all that good stuff, like so much fun, had a great life. Loved it. Doesn't make that much money currently in 2020. Also, it was a passion and a love that I stopped having deeply for. So I transitioned into retail marketing. I'm the retail marketing coordinator at Ethica. My friend Danny, he's the VP. He got me the job because I was like, Danny, she needs to be in corporate. She needs to get some structure and she needs to be responsible and she needs to build a future and a life. So I wanted to do that in the easiest way that wasn't like a stuffy 9-to-5. So I get to have no makeup on and wear sweatpants and it's pretty perfect for me, but there's a lot of skills that I didn't need to have nor were required and be as being a dancer, like anything in regards to technology and any program. So like now, which I have to tell you about my review went deliciously well yesterday, but like just programs that I need to learn for life, like Excel, Adobe, Photoshop, which are things that directly correlate with like my current job, but also like for this podcast, I want to learn how to edit better and like things so that even if I want to transition out of retail marketing, I still really think I like marketing. I think I want to be more in brand marketing, but she can grow. So my pivot is basically every skill set and knowledge that I have of me as like a career woman, and I'm at the baby phase of it. And so my brain has a lot of like, and it's maneuvering it that I'm learning to do. And I'm intentionally learning and putting myself in and my brain in that space of like doing it the best way I can without letting the ebbs and flows like freak me out, because I've already shifted the direction of the pivot. Like, I'm already in the new direction and I have no other choice.
So the power that you take within your pivot is really in your mindset, right? So instead of being like, you know, I have to learn all these new things and I'm so behind and I don't know these things, it's more of just being really ready to learn and accept. Being open-minded, accept things as they come, opposed to being like, oh, I'm so bad at this, or everyone else knows more than I do. when you take the power of the pivot, being in the mindset of like, oh, like I'm starting something fresh, like this is a new opportunity, this is so exciting, opposed to thinking of the negatives.
Right. And it's the negatives are inevitable because like with social media, I still see my old like colleagues and people still dancing and living their best life. And like, I of course had the beginning of like me transitioning. I was like, damn, what are people gonna think? Like, am I, you know, like falling off, like whatever. And that was a moment where I was like, I had to step out and be like, this is what's best for me. And I need to put myself in the best way possible forward in life in general. So like, I have to find some sort of power and empowerment within myself to move forward, or else I'm gonna always doubt and always fear if I'm doing the right thing or not. So like, it's for sure something that once you know is inevitable and it's inside of you and that's like your ultimate journey forward, then it's kind of like you have really no other choice but to accept like the power within it, you know?
Yeah. I think for me, I've had very intentional pivots and very unintentional pivots. For me, I moved to LA, quit my job and moved to LA almost 4 years ago.
Wow.
4 years in April.
Wow.
I know. But that was like an intentional pivot. Like I was like, okay, I'm quitting my job. I'm leaving the boyfriend that I had at the time, leaving my whole family on the East Coast, and I'm going to LA to live out this dream that I have. That's a little bit more easier to carry the power of that pivot because you made it yourself. Once I got here, you know, there was a lot of unintentional pivots where like, career-wise, it went a totally different way for like a year and a half. And then, you know, I was okay with it at first, and then I had hit another pivot and now I'm back in the sports world. So that kind of worked out. Everything just doesn't work on your own timing, right? So instead of me, and I'm not gonna say that I was positive the whole time, because I was not. I was not positive at all.
On it though.
I was so depressed throughout this pivot of like new career stuff. Because I wasn't used to it, right? It was out of my comfort zone. It was nothing I experienced before. I was broke, fi broke, okay? But I will say, like, when I did take some sort of power into that career pivot is when things started changing and working for the better. You know, at this point now, I'm working at Fox Sports in the production realm of things. Yeah. I also am on air digitally with them, which is super cool. I get to cover Lakers and Clippers games.
Plug your show, girl.
So I'm on SFI Next on IGTV and YouTube. So if you follow SFY on FS1, I do production for Speak for Yourself on Fox Sports. So yeah, everything turns out great. But I will say that my first career pivot was
tough.
Devastating to say the least. What I will say is you have to stay positive and truly manifest what you want to happen, whether that's praying or talking out loud or just truly believing that it's going to happen, because it makes a huge difference.
Major.
Huge. Like, you can't be negative Nancy. You cannot. You're going to drown in the negativity. If you don't believe it, nobody else will. And I know that sounds cliche, but that is facts.
And it's as factual as it is, it's a requirement in the pivot process. Okay?
Sure.
What do we got next?
Well, okay, since I mentioned my intentional pivot,
yeah.
I think it's very important to make intentional pivots in life.
Yes.
I am a testimony that, you know, when you do things, because
so sorry.
Who's to say I wouldn't know what my life would be if I did stay on the East Coast or whatever, but I can say now that my life would not be what it is right now, and I'm the happiest that I have been a very, very, very long time. So talking about why it's important to intentionally pivot throughout life.
Okay. Well, what was, you think that to date as an adult was your biggest pivot, is your intentional move from the East Coast to the West Coast?
Yes, because I had to sacrifice a lot to make that pivot. I had to sacrifice a lot. and it was not easy, but it was the most beneficial thing I think I've done to this point. And I think it goes back to, I just,
you're
just, sorry.
It's just crazy. It's my boob.
Going back to, you know, stepping out of your comfort zone, only good things come from that. When you stay in a secure place, when you're playing it too safe, like all you're gonna get is what you already know you're gonna get, and you don't open yourself up to other things and other opportunities that you might not even thought of.
So if you wouldn't have had done that, your life wouldn't have been.
Honestly, like, I just think that, like, I would have stunted my own growth as far as my career goes, because I was working with a startup that I really truly loved, but I had done so much in that city already. I felt like I was comfortable with what I was doing.
Yeah.
Where here, like, I'm not as, I know what the comfortability will get me. And it's not like it's a bad thing. Like I said, playing it safe is good for some people. But because I took a chance, I know it can come from the chance. That's all I do now.
Yeah.
Like, I'm like, oh, I'm with it. Let's go get it however it needs to get done.
Mm-hmm.
So.
That East Coast hustle mentality, Julia. I think one of my biggest pivots, let's say, or like most important pivots in the last like 5 years was probably...
That was intentional.
Mm-hmm. Was like leaving my last relationship, because I think that changed like the entire course of my personal relationship. I mean, my personal relationship with myself, where I was living, my comfort level, my level of settling for tons of shit. And it was really tough because I really was into this person. Like, I had a relationship with their family. Like,
mm-hmm.
It wasn't a bad breakup and a bad thing and a bad person. It just, like, I had the ability to stay in it if I wanted to and would have changed the course of my life. And I knew that that wasn't something that I wanted, but it was very tough for me to, like, pull the plug. Like, it was a very slow bleed of a breakup. But, like, the minute that I did, it was like literal freedom of like, okay, what do I want? I got a dog. Like, I lived on my own for the first time, where I was like, I'm gonna be so upset with myself in this lifetime if I don't live by myself at least for a year. Loved it, hated it, but like, I did it and I'll never regret that. But like, if I stayed in that kind of safe place, I wouldn't be where I'm at. So I'm very, very happy about that intentional pivot. And just, you just have to do it. Like, it sucks. Like, mine took me like a year, but I was like, damn.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, and I had to think into the future. Like, I had to be like, okay, if I stay in this like this, be realistic with yourself, what is your life gonna be?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, nah. Conventional ain't my thing, and this is looking like it's gonna be the most conventional life, and it just wasn't it. But
yeah.
Once you feel it in your gut and you know that you need to like either pull a plug on something or like change it, just like do it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like the jump is the hardest thing, and then once you're there, you're like, oh.
I'm floating in air.
Yeah, like, what the hell? Why didn't I do this like a year ago?
Yeah, and honestly, even if it's not as big as moving across the country or,
breaking up with somebody
that you love or whatever the case may be, even if it's something like, you know, if you haven't done poetry and you like poetry, like, go to an open mic. Or if you, you know, like, do something small that you haven't done. If you just like, oh, I've always wanted to do this hobby and I don't do it. Like,
mm-hmm.
Take the intentional pivot of and the power within it, and make sure that you take that pivot and change the direction a little bit so that you're able to do that. Because sometimes I think we get wrapped up in like our everyday job and our everyday life of what we're doing and what our routine might be, and you don't think about there is time for anything else that you want to do. You just have to make time for it. And the biggest thing that I always think when I'm like sitting on the couch and having a lazy day is like, dang, Beyonce is probably up. So let me get up.
You know who I think of?
Who?
Diddy.
Oh, that's
anytime that I'm chilling, I'm like, what is Diddy doing right now?
Mm-hmm.
Not what I'm doing, darling. And I need more. I need Diddy money. Okay?
Yeah, so if whatever little small leap you need to take to then make a big leap in the end goal.
And honestly, like, you'll see
that.
For sure. I think that you'll also see that your intentional small leap will lead you to like the unintentional, God-given, blessed pivot that's gonna happen that's gonna be like, oh my God, if I didn't take that little leap that took every ounce of courage in my body to do, this opportunity wouldn't have presented itself.
Yeah. And another big one is, even if you have to go to like a networking event and talk to one, start a conversation with one person, like that's just changing the direction of what you normally do. You're gonna meet people. And honestly, I mean, it's not just here in LA, but like here in LA specifically, like, you only get jobs if you know somebody. Like, it don't matter what that resume look like. If you have to know somebody that can put your resume on the desk.
Somebody.
I thought you were gonna go, oh, somebody. Oh, last topic we'll talk about, because this is an important one too. When somebody knows going through a big pivot in life and how to uplift them through that, so that they can have, you know, embrace that power that's within that pivot
and help them have a positive pivot.
Me and this girl right here, okay, we was both going through really hard pivots a couple years ago. Tough. And we did not know about the power of the pivot at the time, and I don't think either of us really knew that we were going through big pivots at the same time, just in different spaces. And I think we're cousins, so like she gotta deal with me the rest of her life. But even in friendships and stuff, and I mean, some people don't talk to their family, whatever the case may be. I think when you're both going through a pivot, or somebody's going through a pivot and having a hard time, it's easy for that relationship to kind of spiral downward. Mm-hmm. You gotta be there to inspire somebody to get through that portion of life, especially if it's taking them to a low place. With us now, we communicate so much. If we're going through something, like, it'll be like, girl, I've been crying for 5 days, don't fucking speak to me, but speak to me.
Hello, I'm very overwhelmed, my day sucks.
Yeah, like,
literally
for your friend.
This week she walks into my house and I'm just hysterically crying. And I'm like, my life sucks and I'm breaking down.
So you have to be there to be the support, the uplifter, and just, you know, keep the positivity going, because you don't want to lose friends over something that is
so personal,
avoidable,
right? And it's like, if they're going through it, there's no need for y'all friendship to like anything happen. It's just like, how do you need to be cared for? What do I need to care for? And like, let's get through it, because like, you're gonna have to get through it ultimately. And if I love and care about you, I'm gonna have to help you.
Right. And that's just in life in general, even if it's not your friend, you know, if you're walking down the street and somebody's going off about something, just think they could be going through a pivot, and like,
and they might not have anybody.
You don't have to go through the negative place too, you
know? And the best thing is just like, you can just say, have a blessed day.
And smile and keep it pushing, you know? Cause positivity really does change things. One smile brings another smile into the world, and that's all you can do at the end of the day. But that's all we have for today. Hope you guys got a little something out of we got from our Women Empowerment Luncheon, as far as the power of the pivot. Staying positive, inspiring others, inspiring yourself to be the best you that you can be every single day, regardless of what you're going through.
Okay, darling. Stay fearless.
Yes, fearless. And I was going to try to give you another word, but I can't think of one.
Next week.
Fearless and positive. I'm going positivity. Positivity all year long. Rest of your life. Life change. But if you don't already follow us on social media, make sure you guys do at Same Sis Podcast on all platforms. Make sure that you are subscribed. Look in the caption. I was going to say comments. Look in the caption below to see where you can follow us to get all of our episodes.
I thought you were going to say look in the cop merchandise. I was like, we don't have that yet. But yes, like, subscribe.
Yes.
Follow.
We'll be comment. Giving out gold every week. So don't miss out on anything. And if you want to follow us individually, you can follow me at Shay Live on Instagram.
And me at Aja DePaolo on Instagram.
and
Twitter.
Yeah, my Twitter is _ShayLive, but I don't really tweet. I'm gonna try. That's something I need to get into in 2020. You know what we need to do is get a TikTok. That's what I heard is the new move. So
we're gonna make a TikTok.
Maybe I'll make a TikTok.
We'll make a TikTok. And if anything, on this page, we'll have links to everything. All things.
So just Same Sis Podcast is really all you need, and you can go from there. Peace out. You make me happy. This you can bear.